Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss how to draw the graph of a polynomial. So for that I am going to take the example x square plus x minus 6. So first thing you need to do is drawing a line neatly for writing the x values as well as y values and x comma y values. Now, any number you can substitute in the place of x. So, some negative numbers I will take and some positive numbers and a 0 I will take. Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. These numbers I am going to substitute in the place of x. Then I will check what values I am going to get in the place of y. Let us check. The given polynomial is x square plus x minus 6 that I am taking as y equals to x square plus x minus 6. Whatever the polynomial they gave in the question, that polynomial I am equating it to y. Now let us substitute one by one number in the place of x. The first number we have is minus 3. So in the place of x, I am going to substitute minus 3. So y equals to, here x square is there, so in the place of x substituting minus 3 whole square plus of, in the place of x again minus 3 minus 6 as it is. So y equals to minus 3 whole square 9 plus into minus 3 minus 3 minus 6. Y equals to 9 minus 3, 6 minus 6. Y equals to 6 minus 6, 0. So when I substituted minus 3 in the place of x, I got the answer 0. So that we will write it as minus 3 comma 0. Okay, now I am going to substitute minus 2 in the place of x. Okay, now I'll substitute minus 2. So y equals to, here x square is there, in the place of x minus 2. Whole square plus, in the place of x minus 2 minus 6 as usual. So y equals to minus 2 whole square 4 plus into minus 2 minus 2 minus 6. So y equals to 4 minus 2 2 minus 6. Y equals to 2 minus 6 minus 4. So when I substituted minus 2 in the place of x, I got the answer minus 4. Here minus 4. This can be written as minus 2 comma minus 4. Next, I am going to take minus 1. I will substitute minus 1 in the place of x. In the place of x, I am going to substitute minus 1. So y equals to, in the place of x minus 1 whole square plus, in the place of x minus 1 minus 6. Y equals to minus 1 whole square plus 1 plus into minus minus 1 minus 6. Plus 1 minus 1 cancel. So we remains with minus 6. Y is equals to minus 6. When we substituted minus 1, we got the answer minus 6. This can be written as minus 1 comma minus 6. Next we have 0. So in the place of x, I am going to substitute 0. So y equals to, Here x is there in the place of x, 0, 0 square, plus again x is there, 0, minus 6. So y equals to 0 square is 0 plus 0 minus 6. Y equals to 0 plus 0, 0 minus 6. Y equals to 0 minus 6, minus 6. So it means when we substituted 0 in the place of x, we got the answer minus 6. Minus 6, that can be written as 0 comma minus 6. Now we have the next question, sorry, next number, plus 1. So I am going to substitute plus 1 in the place of x. So y equals to, here x square is there, 1 square, plus x is there, 1 minus 6. Y equals to 1 square is 1 plus 1 minus 6. Y equals to 1 plus 1, 2 minus 6. Y equals to 2 minus 6 minus 4. So when I substituted 1 in the place of x, I got the answer minus 4. Here minus 4, so we will get 1 comma minus 4. Next number is plus 2. I am going to substitute plus 2 in the place of x. Okay, let us substitute plus 2 in the place of x. So y equals to, here x square is there, nothing but 2 square, plus x is there, nothing but 2 minus 6. So y equals to 2 square, 4 plus 2 minus 6. Y equals to 4 plus 2, 6 minus 6. Then y equals to 0. When I substituted 2 in the place of x, I got the answer 0. So at 0 here, so we will get 2 comma 0. Next last number is 3. So I am going to substitute 3 in the place of x. So y equals to, in the place of x, 3 square, plus x is there again, 3 minus 6. So y equals to 3 square, 9 plus 3 minus 6. Y equals to 9 plus 3, 12 minus 6. Then y equals to 12 minus 6 is 6. When I substituted 3 in the place of x, I got answer 6. So here 6. So it means 3 comma 6. Now we got all the values of x as well as y. So complete table was filled. Now by using these points, we need to draw the graph. Observe all the points here. Minus 3 comma 0, minus 2 comma minus 4, minus 1 comma minus 6, 0 comma minus 6, 1 comma minus 4, 2 comma 0 and 3 comma 6. These are the points which we got. These all the points we are going to plot it on the graph. Okay, here I have the graph. Starting from the origin. Zero, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. All the right side completely positive numbers. Left side negative numbers. And up positive numbers, down negative numbers. Okay, let us represent one by one point on the graph. So before going to that, don't forget writing the axis. This is capital X, X axis, this is X dash, and this is Y axis, this is y dash. So x x dash y y dash. Now if we observe the points, the first point we have is -3, 0. So -3, 0. This is the point -3. Anyway, y coordinate is 0 only, so no problem with that 0. So -3, 0. Next, second point we have -2, -4. This is -2 and this is -4. If we observe -2 line and -4 line, where those two are touching with each other, that point will become -2, -4. It's nothing but this point, -2, -4. Next, third one we have -1, -6. So this line is -1 and this line is -6. Where those two lines are touching with each other, it is this point. So that will become -1, -6. So this point will become -1, -6. So we got -1, -6 also. Next point, if we observe, we have 0, -6. 0, anything, no problem with that. So -6, y coordinate. So this is -6. So that point will become 0, -6. Next, if we observe, we have 1, -4. 1, -4. This is 1. And this is -4. So, where those two are touching with each other, this is the point of coordination of those two lines. So, that will become 1, -4. That is 1, -4. Next, we have 2, 0. So, 2, 0 is nothing but 2 is x-axis, 2 is x-axis and 0 is y-axis. So on the x-axis at point 2, we need to keep one point. That will become 2, 0. Next we have 3, 6. This is 3 and this is 6. So where those two are touching with each other, this point, that will become 3, 6. Now, after plotting all the points on the graph paper, something it is looking like this. Now, we need to join all those points with the hand, not with the scale. Let us check once. Joining all these points with the hand only normally. So, now if we observe where the graph is touching the x-axis, the graph is touching the x-axis at point 2 as well as at point -3. The graph is touching the x-axis at 2 and -3. So the graph is touching at the points 2 and -3, so that these two points, those are 2 and -3, are called as roots or zeros of the given polynomial x² + x - 6. So now, what are the precautions we need to take in this before drawing the graph, otherwise after drawing the graph? The first and foremost thing we need to check is whether we wrote all the x-axis, y-axis or not. X, x-dash and up y, lower y-dash. Next thing is writing the scale. This is very, very important thing. So, right side topmost corner, write the scale. Scale on x-axis, on y-axis. Here every box will be 1 centimeter compulsory in the graph paper. So, 1 centimeter equals 2. Now, on the x-axis also we took as 1 only. On y-axis also we took as 1 only. So, 1 centimeter equals to 1 unit. And on y-axis also 1 centimeter equals to 1 unit. This is the scale. Next thing we need to check is, take the given polynomial, that is x² + x - 6. Split the middle term into 2 terms. x square, x can be written as 3x minus 2x minus 6 as usual. From the first and second term, we can take out x common. So, we remains with x plus 3. From the next to third and fourth term also, we can take out minus 2 common. Again, we will remains with x plus 3. So, here x plus 3 is there, x plus 3 is there. Write it once, x plus 3. Times here remaining is x, here remaining is minus 2. So x plus 3 into x minus 2 will become the factors. Here x plus 3 is there, so minus 3 is the 0, and minus 2 is there, plus 2 is the 0. So this will become the exact answer on the graph also. It means the graph need to touch the x-axis at plus 2 and minus 3, plus 2 and minus 3. Yes, it is touching at plus 2 and minus 3 only. So, we got this correct. And next thing you need to check is, after splitting the middle term into two terms, the values you got, that is 2 and minus 3, make sure that you took these values even in the x-axis, x also in the box, 2 and minus 3. Yes, you took 2 and we took minus 3 also. Make sure that those two numbers which are zeros of the polynomial are also there in the box. This is how exactly we will draw the graph of a polynomial. Thank you everyone. Till now, if you didn't subscribe to my channel, subscribe for more videos. Thank you.